What happens after Brexit? Future EU trade relations with the UK? French President Emmanuel Macron? The situation in Turkey? The euro? Women and Islam? All these issues were discussed during the ECR study days in Berlin.
I was against Brexit, of course. I hoped that the last country with common sense would remain in the European Union, but now they have decided. So here may be an opportunity for Great Britain to finally show the rest of Europe we can be more competitive because we are the master of our own destiny, including our own currency.
MEPs also discussed the new French president, who has already become one of the most important political figures in Europe.
He's very much in favor of EU, but he says he's no federalist. On the other hand, he wants to have European Minister of Finance and European Army and all that. So that's one of his problems, that he speaks in contradictions.
Current developments in Turkey was next on the agenda. This panel was chaired by the ACR president Jan Zaradil.
Turkey is, of course, a very important partner. It's an economic partner, security partner, also geostrategic partner. And the truth is that there are some concerns over the recent developments in Turkey.
The current generation Y, people born between 1980s and 2000, have different priorities than their parents and a different attitude towards standard 9-to-5 jobs. Communication with these millennials can be a big challenge for politicians.
Generation Y and work 4.0. This is what is happening at the moment, and many of us don't even know what it means. We hear it, but we don't know what it means.
Security and terrorism are among the key issues that worry Europe. However, more Europe is not the answer to Europe's security problems, warned Jeffrey van Orden during his panel on security.
We had the very broad topic of security, and that covers a whole range of issues. Terrorism on the one hand, resilience of our infrastructure, all of those sorts of things, right to the other end of the spectrum, the war fighting threat, the possibility of weapons of mass destruction being in the hands of non-state actors, in other words, terrorist groups.
Greece and other southern European countries are still struggling with deep economic problems. According to the ECR's economic expert, the common European currency euro is the main reason for this crisis.
These countries should decide, do they want to stay in the euro? But if they do, then they should be willing to accept that they will not receive transfers, that we will stick to the European treaties, that we will honor the no bailout clause of the Treaty on the Functioning of the European Union. Or do they prefer to leave the euro and reintroduce their own currency, which would give them much more freedom, but of course also would sort of loosen the discipline that the euro, if it is administered in the way in which it was actually designed, if the discipline that this euro imposes on them or would impose on them if we stick to the treaties.
Women have the same value in the eyes of God. They need to have the same position in society as well, argued speakers on the concluding panel, Women and Islam.
I think it's a very important topic. A lot of my colleagues had some misunderstandings, misconceptions of Islam.
This is the most difficult problem and the most problem in Islamic world, why we don't have any democracy in Islamic world. They have to start to think about gender apartheid. They have to understand and accept that men and women are equal. This is the first step to democracy.